Thousands have lived without love, but not even a single one without water. Water is life's matter and matrix, mother and medium. I think no one will have been in this whole planet Earth which would have been unaware of the importance of water. So, keeping in mind this much importance of water, I have brought to be today's topic, which is related to this important water only. But before starting this video, let me request you something, that please watch the whole video, then only you will be able to understand today's topic, which is anomalous expansion of water. So, what is this anomalous expansion? Before learning about this phenomenon, anomalous expansion, we will have to learn about some very basic terms which are related to physics. What are these basic terms? These are density, expansion, contraction. Do you know about these terms? Let me tell you once again. You must have learned in your previous classes that every substance, no matter that is solid or liquid or gas, every substance is made up of atoms or molecules. Atoms and molecules are the smallest units of any substance. So whenever all these atoms are closely combined together and closely packed together, then this type of substance is known as solid. And whenever these molecules are arranged little bit farther from each other or one another in comparison to solids, so they make liquids. But what happens in case of gaseous substances? In gaseous substances, the atoms are arranged very rarely, means very far from each other. So this is the basic structure of every substance. In solids, atoms are close to each other. In liquids, comparatively farther. And in gases, they are completely, means the atoms or molecules are completely free to move in any direction. So why we are learning about the structure of substances, gases, liquids and solids? This is not our topic, but it is very important because the concept of expansion and contraction would be understood with the help of the basic structure of the substances only. Whenever the molecular gap between two molecules in any substances increases, that means expansion is taking place. And whenever the molecules come closer to each other and they start compressing each other, this phenomenon is known as contraction. But now the question arises, when and how does this expansion take place? And why do the molecules go away from each other or they come close to each other? So, what are the reasons inducing or stimulating this act? The biggest factor which is responsible for movement of molecules in any direction, that is heat. If heat is supplied to any substance, the molecules go farther from one another. That means the expansion takes place. And in contrast, or in vice versa, whenever the heat is taken up from any substance, the molecules come close to each other. So that is why the contraction takes place. So expansion takes place whenever the heat is supplied to any substance, whether it is solid, liquid or gas. And contraction takes place whenever the heat is pulled up, means the substance becomes colder. This phenomenon of expansion and contraction is followed by almost each and every element on this planet Earth. That means water must also follow this phenomenon or concept, but it does not happen. Whenever the water is heated up, the molecular distance starts increasing and it starts evaporating. Like other substances, that means the expansion is taking place. The water is in liquid form and now it is getting converted into the vapor form or gaseous form. It follows the same rule as in other substances. But whenever it comes to the cooling process or freezing process, Something different happens. What is that different? Let me tell you. This different type of phenomenon is named as anomalous expansion of water. Whenever we heat up the water, it starts expanding like other substances do. But whenever we cool up the water up to 4 degree centigrade temperature, it remains regular. That means the contraction takes place. But as soon as it reaches to the temperature of 4 degree centigrade, what happens? Instead of contracting, the water starts expanding, and till 0 degree centigrade temperature, it completely expands. That means instead of contracting, it expands, and which is completely opposite to the behavior of all the other known substances on this planet Earth. This is known as anomalous expansion. Why it is known as anomalous? Anomalous means which is not normal, that is completely abnormal. So this type of abnormal behavior of water in comparison to other substances is known as abnormal or anomalous expansion of water. Let's understand the whole process in an instance. What happens on heating? Whenever any substance is heated up, the expansion takes place. Means जब किसी भी substance को गर्म किया जाता है तो वो substance जो है फैलता है, उसमें expansion होता है. और जब किसी substance को cool किया जाता है, उसे ठंडा किया जाता है, तो contraction होता है. Means उसके molecules पास पास आते हैं और वो contract होता है. ऐसा इस अर्थ पर जितने भी एलिमेंट्स हैं, सब्सटेंसेस हैं, सबके साथ होता है. लेकिन वाटर के केस में क्या होता है? Whenever the water is heated up, it expands. जैसे सारे substances गर्म करने पर expand होते हैं, water भी expand होता है. Expand होने पर क्या होगा? It will start evaporating and it will turn into vapors. लेकिन जब इसे cool किया जाता है, तो जब तक जैसे 100 degree centigrade पर है, cool किया, 90 पर आया, 80 पर आया, 70 पर आया, 60, 50, 40, 30 and so on. ऐसा process, कॉन्ट्रैक्शन का प्रोसेस, जैसे जैसे पानी ठंडा होता जाता है वो कॉन्ट्रैक्ट होता है. ऐसा तब तक होता है जब तक कि उसका टेम्परेचर 4 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड तक नहीं पहुंच जाता है. जैसे ही वाटर का टेम्परेचर 4 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड पर पहुंच जाता है, उसकी कॉन्ट्रैक्टिंग प्रोसेस जो है वो वहीं स्टॉप हो जाती है. और कॉन्ट्रैक्ट होने के बजाय अब वो फैलना शुरू होता है. ऐसा अजीब टाइप का बिहेवियर केवल और केवल वाटर के केस में होता है. इसीलिए इसे एनोमलस एक्सपेंशन ऑफ वाटर कहते हैं, जो वाटर की एक बहुत ही ब्यूटीफुल और बहुत ही लाइक पेक्यूलियर क्वालिटी है, क्योंकि ऐसी क्वालिटी किसी और सब्सटेंस में देखने को नहीं मिलती है. दिस इज़ नोन एज एनोमलस एक्सपेंशन ऑफ वाटर. So friends, by now you must have understood the concept of anomalous expansion of water. But still, if you have any doubts, you can ask me in comment section. And one more request, please do like, share and subscribe my channel to see more of my videos. Thanks for watching.